Governments lie all the time. Oh, not just the American government. It's just in the nature of governments. Well, they have to lie. And since they don't represent the people, and so since they act against the interests of the people, the only way they can hold power is if they lie to the people. People the truth, they wouldn't last very long.
With nothing but niceness, sailing west in attempt to find golden spices, dominated by the popes and frenzy for ISIS. The Catholic Church expelled Jews and claimed it was righteous. The first man to see land would get a reward and get a yearly pension for life, clearly from God. A young sailor saw land, said we isn't far. Columbus lied, said he saw it the evening before. They touched ground, they were greeted by the Arawak. Columbus had them locked up as prisoners in an hour flat. He wanted to find a source of gold, and that was that. And when they thought that wasn't fair, then he stabbed they back. When there was no more gold, he took slaves instead, and left a quarter million Indians in Haiti dead. The men died in mines, the women died at work, the children died from lack of milk, and they died in the dirt. They were just taking advantage of a passive people. They were just being the savages of massive evil. That's the church work, that's the path of massive ego. That's the blood of Abraham being stabbed by the steeple. At 16, 19, they were patiently waiting for a ship to carry slaves that was changing the nation. The white man was a cannibal praying to Satan. Hatred, contempt, or pity, or patronization. That's the cornerstone everything racism based in. The African had a more advanced civilization. Black was slave, master was white rationalization. 50 million dead, that's Western civilization. At first they appeared in the north, and they were helpless in the face of superior force. And all of them were chained together, they really was lost. Racism isn't natural, it's merely divorce. Before the slave trade, black was considered distasteful. By the Oxford Dictionary, I find it disgraceful. It's not a natural tendency to be bitter and hateful. It's a natural enemy of the critical staple. Slavery grew as the plantation system grew. The reason for that's kinda easily traceable. Society of helpless dependence was capable of saying, fuck a slave master, you in slavery too. Seven slaves were put to death for murdering master. Fear of slave revolt had them developing faster. You were cattle. A lean killer, an elegant bastard. I would burn the white man while smelling the ashes. From time to time, white man was part of the resistance. White indentured servants wanted no part of the system. King Philip's war showed that if people would listen, that they could maybe break the complex chain of oppression. Tyranny is tyranny, but that's a concession. But the women, they was treated like that of possessions. Black women had it work cause they was abused. That's the white justification of Aryan blues. The next move was to dominate the Mexicans. James Polk dominated them like they was Mexican. He sent Colonel Cost a lot of them and let them in. 11 days later, his skull was crushed, so message sent. We take nothing by conquest, that was the mantra. The military wasn't human, they were just monsters. Henry David Thoreau refused to pay his taxes. Denounced the Mexican War and got locked in shackles. The 20th century opened, anger reemerged. Reality of ordinary life was being heard. Anarchists and feminists came from factory work. Communism, socialism seemed to be rebirth. War is the health of the state, is what Bourne said. And if you was born around that time, you was born dead. The Espionage Act had people confused, cause it was double.